Ken Jeong, great to see you. Thank you so much for coming on. You look fantastic, and thanks for playing that game with us.
Thank you so much. That was amazing. D-Wade.
D-Wade?
I mean, literally, he's basketball legend.
Yeah, Dwayne
part
Wade.
Part of the Big Three. I mean, we're literally doing a thing with D-Wade. It's amazing.
I have to ask you a question. It's serious. I hate to get serious.
Yeah, let's do it. That's what I'm known for.
Yeah. Well, I saw you at the Emmy Awards presenting with Joel McHale.
Oh, God. We really have to talk about that right now?
He's hilarious.
Well, he's a mercy booking. I was supposed to, like, do this. Yes, I was supposed to present alone, you know, because that's what I do. Just like me in my social life, I'm alone. So I presented alone, and Joel's like, oh, God, please come on. He's like the Microsoft thing. Like, well, let me have, like, present with you. Let me just do it. And that's exactly how he talks.
Yeah, he does that. Close your eyes. It sounds like Joel McHale.
And
then
he had the audacity at the Emmys to say I was thrown out of medicine. I used to be a doctor. And he said, I killed the guy. How dare he?
Oh, my God.
Wow.
That is ridiculous.
I got him on Community. I was the star of that show. I was a romantic lead. Yes. Six seasons in the movie. I was the romantic lead of the show.
Okay.
Joel McHale was the rubbery face, little character actor guy that would, like, have one sentence and then steal a scene and then F off. He was that guy. But, like, look, we're handsome leading men.
But here's...
Who should be alone.
No, so you got out there with Joel, and it was fine, and he did that thing. He definitely besmirched the name of Ken Jeong.
I think he did.
And then afterwards, this is what I couldn't believe.
What?
He took a selfie with you and Anthony Anderson.
Are you kidding?
At the party.
Are you really gonna? Let
me show the selfie. Here's you, Ken Jeong. Ken Jeong with Joel McHale and Anthony Anderson.
Wow, that is like okay. You know what? Seriously.
It's unbelievable. I hope he's watching.
I'm not blaming you because you're a peach and we're fellow leading
men. Yes, thank you.
But that Joel is already hearing from my lawyers. You know what I mean? Like, literally, this is not fair. They just show the tip of my nose.
Yeah.
That makes it into the shot. I got him in the Emmys and this is how he repays me? Wow.
But you know
what? I'm taller than him.
Can I just say that?
He was on 3 Apple boxes. I'm 6'8", as D. Wade. He was like, I'm a big fan, Mr. Chow. I was like, you got it. No? That's what we're talking backstage. He was like, God damn, you're so tall.
Yeah, that's what he said to you.
You're right.
That's
you're
what he
right.
said. Yeah, you said that to him.
Yeah, yeah. That's exactly
right.
That's how I talk to D. Wade. That's how I talk to everybody in the NBA.
You do?
Yeah. Hi, Chow. I go, hey.
Right. Well, they had all these these reunions on the Emmys, and it was here's one with you, Joel, and Donald Glover.
Oh, wow, that's nice.
That's Community.
Yes, yes. At last, taking a photo with someone from Community I respect and love. He was a waiter. Look at him.
No, he's not
a
waiter.
Like this. That was... I was like, oh, you got my drink wrong. Oh. Amazing.
That's what you were saying there?
Yeah. I was like, oh, how did he get in here? Oh! Oh, my God, it's supposed to be superstars like you, me, and D-Wade.
Is there any truth to the rumor of a Community movie?
Well, cautious optimism. Yeah! That's the name of my album, The Roots. No, that's the name of my album, Cautious Optimism.
Yeah, so yes.
Yeah, tape dropping next Tuesday. Hopefully.
All right, so we'll see. They're working on the script.
Yeah, they're working on. Right now, I mean, it's really getting everyone's schedule aligned. I mean, like Donald Glover, the biggest star in the world.
He is.
Get his schedule aligned. You have Danny Pudi, Gillian Jacobs, Alison Brie, Yvette Nicole Brown, Jim Rash, who is an Oscar winner. We're all really busy. Joel's very available. He's like welcome. He's like available anytime.
So Joel is ready to. He's on board.
He's on set right now. Oh my God, I'd love to serve drinks. You know, that kind of thing. But no. I mean, we may or may not. People are like, is this really happening? We may or may not be best friends in real life. He may or may not be one of the most decent people I've ever met. I may or may not have had dinner with him and his lovely wife, Sarah, and his adorable sons, Eddie and Isaac. He may or may not have had this redecorated terrace at his home that is absolutely gorgeous. But
no.
I have to say, he's still a horrible human being.
Okay, thank you, Ken, let's talk about something else we can all agree on.
Yes.
First of all, hi, Joel. But we were... I was very excited to see this. You just announced that you're starring in a big Super Bowl commercial.
Oh, yeah.
This is a giant deal.
Well, it's one of those things where, look, I was a doctor from... I grew up in New Orleans, where I did my medical residency. Thank you! And it's my first big Super Bowl ad with Popeye's Chicken that started in New Orleans. And it's cool? Very full circle because, no joke, I would, after a long shift, I'd work like 36 hours saving lives, Joel, saving lives.
Thank you.
I would come back and just have, like, literally right in Metairie, just a suburb of New Orleans, I would always, like, just like clockwork every lunch, I would have, like, a spicy chicken sandwich and then go home. And even, I was just in New Orleans a couple years ago doing a commencement at Tulane, and my only request on my rider was to have, like, a Popeye spicy chicken sandwich.
Are you kidding?
For real.
You manifested this.
Manifested this, so it there's a big full circle.
It's the first time Popeyes has ever done a commercial
first
during the Super Bowl.
First time they've ever done a Super Bowl ad, and then it's a lot of fun. You know, I'm not, you don't plan for things like that in life, but when something like this is something like you're legit a part of, and I still got my dog, a golden doodle named Mocha. I got her in the spot as well, so it was a lot of fun.
It's the best,
it was great, and Joel's not in it. It's
We don't have to stop keeping him.
He's not in it.
We don't have your full commercial we can show here, but we're allowed to show you a little teaser.
Thank you.
Little teaser. Let's take a look.
Thank you.
That's really funny, bud. Oh my gosh, he's waited that long. Oh, I cannot wait for that. That's gonna crush, man. You know I'm the biggest fan of yours. I can see your voice, by the way. Congrats, you do a great job hosting this show.
Oh, thanks.
Do you like hosting?
I do, you know, it really is. And real talk, by the way, I can see your voice. If there's a passion project that's like a game show, this is that. It reminds me of Extreme Makeover Home Edition, where it's just one contestant and you want to win that contestant life-changing money. And that, for me, the biggest compliment is just like, you get to see kind of the real me. I'm just happy for other people when they're winning. It's really about everything else and not about me or anything. People say, this is where I get to see you as a real person. And that, it really is like, it's such a lovely crew, and again, we're all like family.
You can tell that you do it with love. You do a fantastic job.
And no joke, I'm not saying this because I'm on your show, but I do think of you a lot when I do this, because you at your best as a person, when you are happy for other people, that is a mood, you know. And then that is what something I'm trying to duplicate on my show is like being happy for other people, genuinely happy. Is a mood, and that's just, I don't do it for anybody else but for me.
Yeah.
And I'm always like, that's you want to be happy, you want to be sad, you want to just feel it. And I think that to me is the best part of hosting a show. And so yeah, you're a big part of that.
I'm not the same.
Thank you, buddy. Yeah. I want to show a clip. Here's Ken Jeong, and I can see your voice. Take a look.
I was watching her when she sang Bee. She like did a thing with her mouth that I feel like only a singer would do. I think she may be a good singer.
The one thing I noticed was she never said the word eagle. She said ego.
But that could be a diva
little
theme.
Clues.
No.
No, okay, I'm sorry.
Dionne Warwick says no.
Yeah,
you
so
listen
sweet.
To it.
The sweetest person.
You are the best, bud, every time. Thank you so much for coming on the show. Ken Jeong, everybody! I Can See Your Voice, Wednesdays at 8 p.m. on Fox. Dwayne Wade joins us after the break. Stick around. Hey, hey.